This video is sponsored by Admirals.com, where you can find answer of all your questions in simple and presentable way to grab maximum marks in your exams. The first attempt to account for bonding in complexes was made by Sedgwick, who extended Lewis' theory of acids and bases to coordination compounds. According to Lewis' theory, a base is an electron donor and an acid is an electron acceptor. In complexes, ligands were considered to be Lewis bases, which donate electron pairs to the metal and form coordinate covalent bond. Stability of these complexes can be explained on the basis of effective atomic number rule. So, the question was, in a given complex, how many ligands can be attached to the central metal atom? For example, in case of potassium hexacyanoferrate, there are 6 ligands attached to iron. So, can we attach 7 or 8 ligands also? Or there is a limit of number of ligands which can be attached to central metal atom. Thus, the number of possible ligands which can be attached to the central metal atom is given by effective atomic number rule. As per effective atomic number rule, in a complex compound, the central metal atom or ion will accept electron pairs from ligands till its effective atomic number becomes equal to atomic number of nearest noble gas. This means the effective atomic number of the central metal atom must be equal to the atomic number of nearest noble gas. So first, what is effective atomic number? The total number of electrons associated with the central metal atom or ion, electrons of metal plus electrons of ligands in a complex is known as effective atomic number. So, it is the total number of electrons with the metal and with the ligands. And what is atomic number of nearest noble gas? For example, if we have central metal from the first transition series, like titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper and zinc, then the nearest noble gas is krypton and its atomic number is 36. This means we can add more and more ligands in a complex till the total number of electrons of metal and ligand becomes 36. We cannot add more ligands if the number of electrons is going beyond 36. So, maximum limit is 36 for these metals. So, let's take the first example, potassium hexacyanoferrate. Here, central metal is iron and its atomic number is 26. So, number of electrons in iron is 26. But in this complex, iron is in plus 2 state. This means it has 2 electrons less. So now, number of electrons are 24. Now, there are 6 cyanide ligands and each ligand donates 2 electrons. So, total electrons from the ligand is 12. That means, now total number of electrons associated with the central metal atom, that is iron, is 24 plus 12, that is 36. This is same as the number of electrons in krypton, which is the nearest noble gas. Similarly, in hexaamino cobalt plus 3, cobalt is central metal atom and its atomic number is 27. But in this complex, it is in plus 3 state. So, 3 electrons less. Therefore, number of electrons are 24. Now, 6 ammonia ligands give 2 electrons each. So, total 12 electrons. Therefore, electrons associated with central metal is 24 plus 12, that is 36, which is again equal to the atomic number of krypton, nearest noble gas. Let's take one more example where molybdenium is the central metal. So, its atomic number is 42 and in this complex, it is in zero oxidation state. So, number of electron remains as 42. Now, 12 electrons are donated by 6 carbon monoxide molecules or ligands. So, in total, number of electrons becomes 42 plus 12, that is 54. Now, this is the atomic number of xenon, which is the nearest noble gas. So, I hope now it's clear. Now, I give you some of the complex molecules where the number of ligands attached to central metal atom is unknown or denoted by X. Please try to find the number of ligands by using the effective atomic number rule and write the answer in comment box. And next comes the advantages of EAN rule. The first advantage itself is that it correctly predicts the number of ligands in the large number of complexes. So, with the help of EAN rule, you can predict the number of ligands which can be attached. So, that is the actual rule. Second, by applying EAN rule, it is possible to predict accurately the coordination number of metals. That means how many coordinate bonds it can form. So, if you know the number of ligands, then that number of coordination bonds it will form, and that will be the coordination number of the metal. So, we can also find out the coordination number of the metal. And thirdly, by applying EAN rule, it is possible to predict whether the compounds are monomeric or polymeric. For example, manganese carbonyl. Manganese carbonyl is a dimer, and this can be proved with the help of EAN rule. As atomic number of manganese is 25, so number of electrons with two manganese atoms is 50. Also, the charge on manganese is 0. Now, number of electrons donated by 10 ligands will be 20, which comes 70. So, still 2 electrons are missing. These electrons are due to manganese-manganese bond formation. So, now there are total 72 electrons with 2 manganese atoms. That means there are 36 electrons with each manganese atom, which is again atomic number of krypton, the nearest noble gas. Thus, EAN rule proves that the manganese carbonyl is a dimer. So, that was all about the effective atomic number rule. And I hope you like this video. Please click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel. Thank you.